click to subscribe to the channel and then press the bell icon to get regular updates of videos, live sessions, and important seminars.
Good afternoon, everyone. I suppose all of you are from political science department only? No, okay, it's a mixed group, okay. How many of you know about UPSC, IAS exam, civil service exam? Many of you know about it. What do you know about this exam? What is civil service? What is this exam all about? What do you become once you clear this exam? You become IAS officer? Bureaucrat? See, when we talk about like IAS officer, IPS officer, IFS, IRS, IRTS, Indian Audit and Account Services, everything is through this one particular exam. We don't have separate exams for IAS or IPS, for IFS. IFS means Foreign Services, but for Forest, we have a separate exam. Okay? So all together, we have like 26 services that come under this particular exam, UPSC Civil Service exam. So once you qualify this exam, then depending on your ranking, you get the various services. It depends on your rank, it depends on your choice also. Many times, first, second, third rankers, they opt for like IRS, they don't want to become IAS, or they might want to become IFS, Foreign Service. So it all depends on your choice as well as your ranking in the exam. So what is the importance of this service? Why so many people want to take up this exam? Because if we don't know what is the importance of this exam, after clearing this, qualifying this exam, if you become something, what will you do? If you don't know about it, then why will you prepare for it? You should be knowing about it. No, ki ye agar main clear karta hoon ya karti hoon, toh what will I become? What will I do? Like, you know ki, okay, if you qualify MBBS, okay, you will be a doctor, you will be seeing the patients. If you qualify engineering, then you get into some kind of a engineering related job. So once you clear this exam, you become a bureaucrat. Then what is, like, how it is different from other exams? Why so many people across India want to be a civil servant? See, bureaucrats, they are the backbone of the administration of the country. Politicians, like most of you are from political science department, you know, okay, every 5 years elections, they happen. Politicians come and go. But who gets the stability into the system? It is the bureaucrat. Who makes the policies? It's not the politicians who are making the policies. It's not only India. Across, even in United Nations, okay, kahin pe bhi aap chale jao, kisi bhi country mein chale jao, wherever you go, it is the bureaucrats, the bureaucracy which is holding the fort. It's not the politicians, because they are coming and they are going. Politicians don't have that in-depth knowledge. They don't have that kind of specialization to make the policies. Okay? Whenever the transit is happening, say for example, government A is right now in the power. Next year, government B would be coming. Say, then who will facilitate this smooth transition? It is the bureaucrat. System mein stability. Otherwise, kya hoga? Bureaucrats bhi har baar change honge. Hai na? Policies aapki jo hain. Kaun banata hai? It is the bureaucrats. So bureaucrats have immense role. Like right now, so many policies are for women. Okay, who is making it? It is the bureaucrat. So many policies like smart cities ki hum baat kar rahe, environment ki baat kar rahe, SDGs ki baat kar rahe, sustainable development goals and all. Who all are making these? These are all your bureaucrats. So this particular position, once you become a bureaucrat, it has lots and lots of opportunity for you. Of course, it's a good career, number one. At the same time, you get good respect, as somebody has said, okay, society mein you have good respect. And at the same time, you are in a commanding position. Okay? Aap bhale Reliance ke chairperson honge, but ek jo power is within IPS officer or within IAS officer, that Anil Ambani or Mukesh Ambani will not be commanding that power. Okay? So that is the beauty of this exam, where you can satisfy your aspirations as well as you can work for the society. Okay? Now, what is this whole exam, like how it is conducted, how many phases are for this exam, do you have any idea? How many of you are willing to take up this exam? Many people, great. See, this exam is conducted in three phases. One is your prelims, second is your mains, and then third is your personality test. Okay? UPSC does not call it interview, it calls it personality test. So in the prelims, and this exam is a specialist or generalist exam. It's a generalist exam because people from different educational backgrounds are taking up the same question papers. Okay? You might be an engineer, you might be a doctor, you might be a Sanskrit graduate, you might be a philosophy graduate, all of them are having the same question paper because IAS is a generalist exam, it's not a specialist exam. So now the prelims, you have GS paper, that is general studies, and then you have a CSAT. Okay? CSAT, you have to qualify it, and once you qualify the prelims, marks will not be added for your mains. Prelims is just a qualifying exam. So once you qualify prelims, then you come for the mains. What all comes under mains is everything under the sun comes under the main paper. Okay? There you have GS papers, paper 1, 2, 3, 4. You have one dedicated paper for essay and one optional you have to choose. And the beauty of UPSC is supposedly you are a commerce graduate, but you have interest in Hindi literature. You can opt for that. They will not say ki you have done your graduation in commerce, so you should take only commerce. Engineers, doctors, many of them are taking literature subjects also. Okay? Or agar aapko maan lo law mein interest hai and you want to take law as an optional, but you have done political science as your graduation, but there is no bar to it. Okay? So you have to take up one optional paper, that's your choice. UPSC has given you the choice. Aap koi bhi usme se le sakte ho. And then you have GS papers. Paper 1 is basically your history, geography. Most of you have raised your hands ki hum prepare kar rahe hain to pata hoga. History hai, geography hai, aapka social issues ke upar questions aate hain. Paper 2 is your political issues are there, okay? Polity, governance, international relations are there. Paper 3 is basically your economics, your disaster management, internal security, science and tech, and paper 4 is your ethics. Ethics, they have introduced this paper, ethics, where they are asking you questions related to ethics. What is like, they want to test your ethics. They ask you simple questions, as simple as like, what according to you is happiness? Okay, aise questions bhi puchte hain. They ask you case studies also, ki supposedly you are put in a certain situation, so how are you going to react to that? Why not? Okay, that kind of thing is there, and then you have two papers for your optional, paper 1 and paper 2. So once you qualify your mains, and then you have compulsory paper, language paper, English paper. Okay, so that is your, just you have to qualify that. Marks will not be added to your merit list for the compulsory papers. Okay? Jo aapka ek, out of your languages that are given in your constitution, unme se aap ek language lenge aur ek aapka English language paper aata. It's just a qualifying paper. But if you don't qualify it, your other mains paper papers are not going to be checked. Okay? And once you qualify the mains, and then it is your personality test. And after your personality test, the final rest is when they add the marks of your mains and your personality test. So this is the basically the system of this exam. Okay, this you can get it from your UPSC website also. If you want to get any information about how the exams are conducted, UPSC website. So let us talk something else. It is said that this is one of the most difficult exams on this earth. Do you know how many people appear for this exam approximately? It is said that yes, every year people who fill up the forms are 8 to 10 lakhs. Okay? And what is like this year, it's like 750 vacancies are there, approximately 750 plus hai, matlab it's not 800 also. So from 8 lakhs to your 700 something. ठीक है तो इट इज दैट इज व्हाई इट इज सेड वन रीजन सेकंड रीजन इज एवरीथिंग अंडर द सन मींस हिस्ट्री ज्योग्राफी इकोनॉमिक्स आर्ट एंड कल्चर ठीक है यू माइट बी स्टडिंग कॉमर्स यू माइट नॉट बी हैविंग एनी इंटरेस्ट इन आर्ट एंड कल्चर आपको लगेगा यार मैं क्यों पढ़ूं इस एग्जाम के लिए इंजीनियर्स को लगता है हम आर्ट एंड कल्चर क्यों पढ़ रहे हैं बट दैट इज देयर इन योर सिलेबस यू हैव टू रीड इट एवरीथिंग जो भी चीज़ें हैं कुछ भी हो रहा है दे आर आस्किंग यू क्वेश्चंस ऑन दैट ठीक है सो दैट इज व्हाई इट इज सेड दैट इट इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट एग्जाम्स ऑन दिस अर्थ बट बिलीव मी दिस एग्जाम इज difficult but not impossible every year people from various backgrounds okay you people are fortunate that you are staying in Delhi you have the advantage of internet and all those things I know people from the remotest of the areas they are qualifying this exam without any coaching institute without any internet services they are doing this exam so this exam is very doable okay this exam is not at all difficult the only thing this exam needs is your persistence continuity in your studies the question that is being always asked is ki kitne ghante padhna hai some people say IAS banne ke liye 18 ghante padhna hai 19 ghante padhna hai theek hai it all depends on an individual it's not that everyone can read 18 hours at least I cannot read 18 hours theek hai but yes people are doing it but on the other side people with only 4 to 5 hours every day dedicatedly for this preparation, they are clearing this exam. And at the age of 22, 23 people are clearing this exam. One example is your Tina Dabi from Delhi University only. 2 years back, she topped first attempt, 22 years, she qualified this exam. And she is just because she was the topper, so she is in the limelight. But if you see the list result every year, so many young people are qualifying this exam so what does this show this shows that this exam is not that difficult the only thing is you need to have focus for this exam and for that sake any exam competitive exam you need to be focused hai na so how to prepare for this exam those who are preparing how are you preparing for this exam from where are you studying these things कहाँ से पढ़ना है इस एग्जाम के लिए क्या पढ़ना है हैव यू सीन द क्वेश्चंस हैव यू सीन द क्वेश्चंस व्हाट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस दे आर आस्किंग योर जनरल स्टडीज सी फॉर दिस एग्जाम हाउ टू स्टडी बिकॉज मेनी ऑफ यू माइट हैव स्टार्टेड स्टडिंग राइट नाउ ठीक है या कुछ टाइम के बाद आप करोगे सो How to prepare for this exam because अभी आप इसके लिए start कर सकते हो because those who are qualifying at the age of 22, 23 वो final year में जाते हैं qualify कर जा रहे हैं इस exam को ठीक है So what to do is your basic NCERTs at least you can start doing that conceptual clarity आपको वहाँ से आनी है ठीक है तो this exam for this exam you don't need to be like you don't need to go into too much of details as a subject matter specialist अगर आप हिस्ट्री पढ़ रहे हो तो आपको हिस्ट्री का मास्टर नहीं बनना है इस एग्जाम के लिए बिकॉज दिस इज अ जर्नलिस्ट एग्जाम ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दिस थिंग ठीक है सो टेक आउट योर एनसीईआरटीज फ्रॉम 10th 11th 12th दैट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प यू बट येस वॉट हैपन्स इज कि राइट नाउ इफ आई एम डूइंग कॉमर्स आई हैव नॉट रेड हिस्ट्री सिंस सो मेनी ईयर्स So I might not be able to grasp the basics. So that is why it is said that then go back to standard 6. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10th, 11, 12th. Okay, NCERTs. That will make your base. At least to develop interest. Another thing is see the question papers. It is available on the websites. ठीक है यूपीएससी के वेबसाइट में भी हैं आपके और इतने सारे नाउ यू हैव सो मेनी ऑफ द वेबसाइट्स आर देयर वेयर यू कैन इजीली गेट द क्वेश्चन पेपर्स एंड सी द क्वेश्चन पेपर्स हाउ दे आर आस्किंग क्वेश्चंस हाउ दे आर आस्किंग द क्वेश्चंस सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस आर डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम योर एनसीईआरटीज ओनली एनसीईआरटीज आर गोइंग टू मेक योर बेस एटलीस्ट दे आर रिटन इन सच अ सिंपल मैनर दैट यू कैन ईजिली अंडरस्टैंड द थिंग्स बिकॉज अगर आपको कोई अभी बोलेगा आप अगर पॉलिटिकल साइंस के स्टूडेंट हैं हो सकता है आपको इकोनॉमिक्स के कॉन्सेप्ट बिल्कुल निकल गए हों दिमाग से रेवेन्यू डेफिसिट क्या है कैपिटल डेफिसिट क्या है तो बेसिक जो बहुत ईजीली समझा रही है वो आपकी एनसीईआरटी समझा रही है, और जब तक आपको इंटरेस्ट नहीं आएगा ना, आप इस एग्ज़ाम को नहीं क्लियर कर सकते हो. तो इंटरेस्ट तभी आएगा जब चीज़ें समझ में आएंगी. समझ में कब आएंगे? जब हम उनको आसान सोर्स से पढ़ रहे होंगे. तो एनसीईआरटी इज़ द बेस्ट, वहाँ से आप उनको पढ़ना शुरू करो. एंड देन कीप ऑन गेजिंग द क्वेश्चन पेपर्स. फॉर प्रिलिम्स यू कैन गो बैक टू 10 years, बट फॉर योर मेन्स 2013 ऑनवर्ड्स, बिकॉज तब से जो है हमारा पैटर्न इन सिलेबस हैज़ चेंज्ड. ठीक है? एंड यू विल सी दैट इस बार का भी अगर आप क्वेश्चन पेपर अभी का लेटेस्ट उठाओगे, 2 हफ्ते पहले आया है, यू विल फाइंड दैट कि मोस्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस विदाउट इवन प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर एग्जाम आपको लगेगा कि मुझे आता है. ठीक है? बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस वो ऐसे पूछते हैं जो करंट से रिलेटेड है, बिकॉज एवरी वन ऑफ अस इज रीडिंग दोज थिंग्स. सो दे आर आस्किंग यू क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू करंट ऑल्सो, बट रिलेटेड टू योर सब्जेक्ट ऑल्सो. से फॉर एग्जाम्पल, दे हैव आस्क्ड, वी ऑल हैव स्टडीड अबाउट इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन, we all, and nowadays we are reading about smart cities, pad rahe hain newspapers mein smart cities pad rahe. So they have asked you question like, what are the similarities and differences between Indus Valley civilization and smart cities? To Indus Valley hum sabne padha hai. The only thing is कि हमने उस टाइम सिर्फ 6th से 7th में जाने के लिए पढ़ा था, है ना? अब हम पढ़ेंगे तो वो ये पढ़ेंगे कि उसके फीचर्स क्या थे, आज वो काम में आ रहे हैं कि नहीं आ रहे. स्मार्ट सिटी की हम बात कर रहे हैं, वेदर वी आर एबल टू कनेक्ट टू दोज फीचर्स और नॉट. दे वॉन्ट टू सी योर एनालिटिकल स्किल्स. ठीक है? करेंटली वी ऑल आर रीडिंग अबाउट ट्रेड वॉर्स इन द न्यूज़ पेपर्स. ट्रेड वॉर पढ़ रहे हैं. दे हैव आस्क्ड यू क्वेश्चंस ऑन ट्रेड वॉर दिस टाइम कि ओके, इफ ट्रेड वॉर इज हैपनिंग, सो वॉट एग्जैक्टली इज ट्रेड वॉर? It is between, mainly between your US and China. So how are we getting impacted? So you need to analyze. Analyze ab tab karoge jab aapke basics clear honge. Basics kab clear honge? Jab aapka interest hoga. Interest tab hoga jab wo cheeze simple tarike se hongi. Theek hai? To read, go through your basic NCERTs. See the syllabus. Syllabus should be on your tips. See the syllabus, see the question papers, and this is very, very doable exam. Not at all difficult. है ना? आप लोग तो दिल्ली में हो, मतलब students who are from very humble backgrounds are clearing this exam. Son of a rickshaw puller, son of a auto rickshaw driver. Do you know someone like this, जिन्होंने exam clear किया? 21 years old, someone from Pune who has qualified this exam. Go and find it out. ठीक है? जिस दिन एग्जाम का रिजल्ट आया था, ही डिड नॉट इवन हैव द मनी टू बाय स्वीट्स फॉर हिज फ्रेंड्स. ही डिड नॉट हैव द मनी टू गो टू अ स्कूल. ठीक है? किसी तरह उसने अपना कैसे कैसे करके ग्रेजुएशन खत्म किया. ही टुक अप दिस एग्जाम एंड एट द एज ऑफ 22, जस्ट अप्रोचिंग 22, ही क्वालिफाइड दिस एग्जाम. नॉट इवन गोइंग टू सम इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल और समथिंग लाइक दैट. सो फॉर दिस एग्जाम अनदर थिंग इज, इट्स नॉट दैट इंग्लिश इज कंपल्सरी. UPSC gives you the option. If you want to take up this exam in Hindi, you are most welcome. We have Hindi, we have English, and even for vernacular languages also. Every year, if certain number of people are interested to write this exam in Tamil, in Odia, in any of the scheduled languages, if the certain number of students are there, UPSC gives you that option, because UPSC wants to take out the best potential of yourself. They want to see your best potential. They are not interested in English or Hindi. वो आपको academy में सिखा देंगे. अभी है कि आप अपना talent उनको दिखाओ, जो आप इस whether you are capable of coming to this particular bureaucratic system or not. They want to test that. So they have given you that option. Another hitch is, many of the students, they say ki we have lot of content, lot of material in English only. We can write English, but we cannot speak English. That is again a hitch. To hum English le le, fir interview mein kya karenge? That is also a question mark many times. Theek hai? These are practical problems, because many times you are not able to express yourself in English better. Kai baar hota hai, bahuton ke sath ye hota hai. So here also UPSC is giving you the leverage. You can take up this exam in English while writing. At the time of interview, they again, not interview, personality test, they again ask you your medium. You can opt for English, you can opt for Hindi, or you can opt for your language, say Marathi. So they will have an interpreter that day. Okay? So UPSC is giving you all leverage. The only thing is best should come out from the candidate. So this exam is not at all difficult. The only thing is you have to be focused and you have to be persistent. Ab ye focus kahan se aata hai? Focus aata hai aapka syllabus se, question papers se. Because this is a competition. ठीक है, हमें यहाँ पे किसी भी सब्जेक्ट एक्सपर्ट नहीं बनना है, हमें कम्पीट करना है. तो कंपटीशन है, तो हमारे को जो सिलेबस दिया है हमको उससे दाएं बाएं, वी डोंट नीड टू मूव हियर एंड देयर. ठीक है, फोकस ऑन द सिलेबस, बिकॉज यूपीएससी डज नॉट गो बियॉन्ड द सिलेबस. ठीक है, सिलेबस आपका दिया हुआ है, यू शुड बी फोकसिंग ऑन सिलेबस, यू शुड बी फोकसिंग ऑन प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर्स, एंड देन एवरी डे रीड न्यूज़पेपर्स एटलीस्ट वन. है ना, फॉर दोज हु आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर यूपीएससी, दे जनरली प्रेफर द हिंदू और द इंडियन एक्सप्रेस. ठीक है, द हिंदू, इंडियन एक्सप्रेस, दोज ऑफ यू हु आर इन द सेकेंड ईयर एटलीस्ट स्टार्ट रीडिंग इफ यू हैव इन योर माइंड दैट यू वॉन्ट टू टेक अप दिस एग्जाम. बिकॉज हिंदू पढ़ने के लिए भी 6 महीने लग जाते हैं. ठीक है, बिकॉज हमें टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया पेज 3, दोज थिंग्स यू विल नॉट फाइंड देयर. ठीक है, द हिंदू धीरे धीरे पढ़ो, इंडियन एक्सप्रेस पढ़ो और क्वेश्चंस को रिलेट करो, एंड वट एवर यू आर रीडिंग इन द न्यूज़पेपर्स ट्राई टू थिंक. खाली पढ़ के नहीं छोड़ना है, उसके ऊपर सोचो. एंड लास्ट थिंग आई वुड से, वेदर यू टेक अप दिस एग्जाम, वेदर यू डोंट टेक अप दिस एग्जाम, बट द बेस्ट थिंग इज इफ यू एक्चुअली प्रिपेयर फॉर दिस एग्जाम, यू कम आउट एज अ वेरी डिफरेंट पर्सनैलिटी. बिकॉज अभी जो है आप पॉलिटिकल साइंस पढ़ रहे होगे, इकोनॉमिक्स पढ़ रहे होगे अपने ग्रेजुएशन सब्जेक्ट में, यू माइट नॉट बी अवेयर अबाउट इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी. You might not be aware about disaster management. Yesterday it has, which cyclone has come? Titli. Why it is named Titli? Is there any authority? Is there any body which names the cyclones? Pehle karte hai ki aane ke baad karte hai, kya karte hai? So well aware, well informed person aap bante ho agar aap is exam ke liye at least prepare karte ho. इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस क्या हो रहा है, कहाँ हो रहा है, हम पे क्या इम्पैक्ट है, इकोनॉमिक्स जीएसटी है तो क्या होगा उसका इम्पैक्ट. ठीक है, सो वेदर यू अपियर फॉर दिस एग्जाम और नॉट, एटलीस्ट आई वुड से, आई ऑलवेज से टू एवरी वन कि प्लीज सिलेबस देखो और थोड़ा सा प्रिपेयर करो, यू विल बी अ डिफरेंट इन्फॉर्म्ड पर्सनैलिटी. एंड मोर ओवर इट्स नॉट अबाउट ओनली यूपीएससी कॉम्पिटिशन, एनी कॉम्पिटिशन नाउ अडेज वेर एवर यू गो it's always a bheed that is following there. So what they want, they have a criteria to sort out the people. They are looking for well informed people. Even in your corporates they are looking for people. Agar engineer unko engineer chahiye to wo bhi dekh rahe hain ki well informed engineer hoga. Agar unko koi accountant chahiye to they also want ki well informed ho. Theek hai, to this exam preparation makes you a very different, very knowledgeable, very informed person. And once you develop love for this information and all, then you will yourself find that this exam is not at all difficult. It's very, very doable. Okay? So now I'll not take much of your time. And now I'll be asking Haris for taking the next session. And he is, in 2016, he has qualified UPSC and he got IRS, that is your revenue services. And 17 IPS, right now he is currently IPS Jharkhand cadre, and I hope he'll get through finally into IAS.
Good afternoon. I hope I'm audible to everyone. Yeah. So first of all, let me thank Next IAS for giving me this opportunity to speak in front of you. It's a great honor for me to speak in front of Ruchika ma'am, because personally we have learned a lot from her, and her motherly affection has always been something which we talk about in the academies when we go to the training. Respected faculty members and my dear students, it's really good for me that I can see so many young faces all ready to enter into bureaucracy, at least if you have not planned yet. So you will plan today, we assume it. See, first of all, I'll tell you there are some myths regarding UPSC, so next like 10-15 minutes I'll be talking about all those myths which we have and which have made this to be the toughest exam in the country and whatnot. Basically, if I start with trying to understand, after your plus two, you go for some or the other graduation, be it sciences, be it engineering, be it, you know, like doctor, like medicine, you need a special aptitude for that. Yes or no? You need a special bent of mind for that. But when UPSC is testing you, UPSC is just asking for basic graduation as the criteria. If you're done with that, you can apply for this exam. And the nature of this exam is such that, trust me, anybody, any one of you sitting in the classroom can make into it. You know, I have friends who have failed in class 9th, failed in class 11th. I'll not name them. They're doing very well in their services. So let us not embarrass them, but they made into the list. So what I'm trying to say here is, you need a clear strategy. See, it's difficult because people are not able to understand what's the way to approach this exam. Once you are clear with that strategy, this exam is one of the easiest in the country. So basically, as ma'am has already told, in fact, this is what I always tell to aspirants, you have two most important things available for you. One is the syllabus and the other is the question paper. By question paper, I mean the UPSC previous year question paper, not the question paper which are available in the market. Why? Because, you know, you always need to map the syllabus. Along with the syllabus, you see the question paper and do a reverse engineering. Because ideally, if you see the syllabus of the exam, you can be frightened at the, you know, first go. Because it is asking you to read about economy, about history, about geography, about polity, about environment, about science tech and current affairs. So you will assume that ye to bahut zyada hai, kaise hoga? It's nothing. Just see the syllabus, see the question paper, map the priority areas. You would understand that these are the areas on which I need to focus and these are the areas which I do not need to read. So this is the one way in which you can evolve your strategy. So in UPSC, there are three things. First, what to read. Second, which is more important, what not to read. And third, how to read. See, I'm sure that we are living in the digital world. A lot of information is available on the net, as ma'am was saying. So you can just Google and you will get a lot and lot of information. My advice would be, do not run behind information. Because information is never knowledge. Try and understand that why it is important to speak to the people who are in this profession, who are mentoring from like 15 years or 20 years, or people who have qualified for this exam. Because you get a sense of direction. That's it. Nobody is going to coach you for this exam. Nobody is going to tell you how to do like this topic from this book. Every day it cannot be told. There are some basic things which I am sure is available on the net. And if there are any queries regarding that, we can take that in the question answer session. But let us assume that there is a basic way, some basic books are there. NCERTs are the best to start with. Along with NCERTs, newspaper, I guess, ma'am, is the most important source. Like for the prelims, for the mains, for the interview, and even after you enter the service, newspapers are the most important source. Because, you know, once you enter the service, it's not that you have achieved something very big. You have to make your profile every day. If you have certain self-image and you want to see yourself doing the top job in the country, you have to cultivate every day. And as our ex-president Dr. Kalam has said, to keep low aim is a crime. So never do that. Fine. So now coming to some of the basic myths of UPSC. You have to read 18 hours a day. I'm sure suna hoga aisa kuch, 18 hours a day. Do I look like a human being? Insaan jaisa dikhta hu main, right? Is it possible? Tell me, is it possible for anyone to read 18 hours a day? And that too when you are preparing for civil services, because it needs time. So if you are reading 18 hours a day for like 6 months or 8 months, either you go to hospital or you are in some or the other kind of depression. See, it's very, very important to dispel some of the myths which we have. Then people will ask, what is the standard time to read, like 6 hours, 8 hours? There is no single answer to it. It depends upon the individual's capacity. Somebody can read more in like 5 hours than somebody else doing that in 10 hours. So if you have that bent of mind, you have that capacity of reading, you can sit for long hours, or even if you're sitting for short hours, what is the aim? The aim is to go for quality. It is never the quantity, it is always the quality. If you have read whole day and you have read those things which are never being asked in the question paper, you have wasted a day. So now, as we have said already, you have to always see the syllabus in the question paper. then only you will know that, you know, whatever you are doing is right, you are on the right track. Fine. So let me explain this with example. You know, now all of you are in college, you must be having academic engagements. So people will ask how to manage time. See, there are n number of examples who have, like, in the very first year after the graduation, they have qualified. There are examples, people who have qualified in their final, like the sixth attempt. So because the exam, this exam is having a lot of diversity. Ages from 21 to 32, people from all different backgrounds. These are some of the variables which is actually, you know, making the competition tough. So here, if you want to beat the other person, you need to be very precise in whatever you are reading. So let's say you start the week with Monday, and on Monday you have some engagements in the college. So after all those engagements, if you can devote like 4 hours or 5 hours, that is more than enough for Monday to Friday or Saturday, whatever is your working day. So if every working day, if you're devoting 5 hours or 6 hours, that is more than enough for now. Try to capitalize weekend. But again, I am not saying ki agar you have studied whole week and on weekend also you should do the same thing from morning to evening. Aisa nahi karna bilkul. Why? Because that will again become a burden for you. If you are not taking breaks in between, uske baad kya hoga ki you will go to social media, you will see your friends posting some of the beautiful pictures where they are traveling, they are doing some parties and all. And you will say, at this age, what am I doing with myself? I am stuck with the book all 24/7. So it's very, very important that once a week you take a break. That break can be of like 5 hours, 6 hours, but it is important. And when you are taking break, do not stay in the place where you are, in a hostel or wherever you are living. Do not stay there. Try to go out. You should change the environment. Because if you are not doing that, you will not be refreshed to start your studies from the next day. You need that refreshment always in this exam. One more thing here. Do not go out with friends who are also preparing for civil services. Never do this. See why I'm saying, I'm sure that all of you must be having some or the other friends who are not preparing for civil services, right? Those friends are treasure. Unko bilkul paas mein rakho apne. Otherwise, kya hoga ki if like 4 people who are preparing for civils, you go out for a break, immediately phone pe ek notification aa gaya that government has brought a new bill. You start discussing like this is the provision, this is the act, and you know, whole idea of taking a break is spoiled. So don't do that. Take a small break every week, that's very important. Try and plan the entire academic year's strategy. Let's say if you are aiming the exam of the next year or next to next year, plan accordingly, because this exam can be done in like 1 year, it can be done in 2 years, and you know, I am sure that nobody would like to have a 5 year plan, because government ne bhi 5 year plan ab band kar diya. Like Niti Aayog is there, there is no planning commission, so don't go for that 5 year plan. It's not at all advisable. So try and make a plan, like if you want to appear next year, so ideally this is a time where you can focus on the optional, you do some of the things of mains. More focus on the mains, because again, you know, the second myth is like how to go about prelims and mains. There is no watertight compartment that I should prepare for, first for prelims, then for mains, and then for interview. Anyways, we don't call it interview, we call it personality test. It's all about your personality, whatever you are in 21 years or more. So what I would suggest, that it's a holistic preparation. Whatever you are reading, try to read it from the perspective of all the 3 stages, at least 2. Prelims and mains, that's very important. There are some of the portions which are new in the mains, like for example in paper 1 you have world history, which is new, in paper GS paper 4 which is ethics, which is new, which is not in the prelims. Those portion you can do it now if you're planning the next year attempt. And the things which are going to continue in news and which are also similar in nature with the prelims, always read them together from this time till the exam of 19th, which is I think on 2nd of June. Acha, between how many of you are planning to take exam next year? Okay, next to next year? Almost all of you next to next year. So this is the perfect time to start. Third myth, what is the best time to start? Always and always, best time to start UPSC preparation is now. Start it. At least if not anything, try and read the newspapers and NCERTs. That will help. So if you are planning the 2020 attempt, always advisable, finish your optional first. Next question, how to choose the option? See, these are the general myths what people will be asking and general doubts. Option kaise choose karna hai? See, option is very, very, very important because option is going to decide your service, your cadre, your career and almost everything. So whenever you are choosing optional, two to three things you should keep in mind. First and foremost, the primary should be, what is your interest? If somebody else has told you that you should take political science or anthropology, don't run behind that suggestion. Take any textbook, start from the basic NCERTs or whatever reference material are available. Read that for some time, at least for a week. If you are developing some interest in that, then only continue that subject, otherwise do not. See the syllabus, see the question paper, read for a week. If you are in sync with the idea of that particular optional, go ahead with that optional. Otherwise, you should think of some other optional. Do not run behind the idea that this optional is getting more marks, this option is getting less marks. See why? Because by the time when you are appearing, 2020, it might change. These days, if anthropology and political science are doing very good, it might not be the case in 2020. So marking pattern is not the idea to decide your optional. Second most important thing is the kind of material which is available and the kind of guidance which is available to choose the option. So if you have enough material, enough guidance, and primarily you have developed interest in that subject, you should choose it. That is really going to help, because optional is the only area, I would say, where you need a little bit of more understanding, analysis and knowledge. By saying this, I do not mean that general studies does not need that. But you know, optional would be needing these things in great detail. So priority should be your interest and the other things which we talked about. Fine? Yeah. Okay. So this is like next, like after optional, how should we go about the entire thing of scheme of things in UPSC? So basically, I am not going to tell you the stages of examination and the syllabus and the books which are available. I will tell you how to do it. So it's very important that, let's say, if you start a subject, for example, ancient history. Now there are some of the important textbooks, let's say R.S. Sharma's NCERT, which is very famous, everyone reads that. Now you take that book, next question would be how to read this book. Is it important to read that book from cover to cover? Absolutely no. In this examination, please try and understand that it is different from the college exam, your school exam, university exam. It is a competitive exam. So you're not supposed to read any book from cover to cover. How will you do it? Again, see the syllabus and see the question paper. Map the important areas, focus on those areas. Once you are done reading, let's say you have started with R.S. Sharma, now you are done reading R.S. Sharma. At the end of the first reading, you should highlight the important points in that book only. If you have more time, you can take out notes, but if you are not having time, at least highlight. So that next time when you are revising it, it will be saving a lot of time. Because ideally you will be reading n number of books, and if you are not in the habit of making notes or highlighting, so the idea of reading once would be lost. Again, in UPSC preparation, we always say that reading one time is not a crime, but a sin. So you should not read one time, fine? Now next myth is again, not myth, next doubt is, what should we do? Should we read one book five times or like five book one time? What do you think? What should be the idea? All of you? Yes, exactly. You have to read one standard book five times. Now, iska matlab ye nahi hai ki ek book five time padh li, usko rakh diya, ab us subject pe kuch bhi nahi padhna hai. Aisa nahi hai. See the question paper. Try and solve some mock test. If you are able to score good marks, you should assume that now you are at least more or less done with this subject. If that is not the case, speak with people who are into guiding you, like who are into guidance, and who have qualified this exam. They will tell you that apart from this, at least go for this book or go for this source and try and enhance your marks. Because you know, first stage, which is prelims, is the stage of elimination. So there around, you know, 10 lakh people will be filling the form, around 5 lakh will be appearing in the exam. From 5 lakh, it will be around 15,000 or 13,000, 14,000, depending upon the vacancies, people who will be writing the mains. So from 5 lakh to 15,000, so So that is why we say that prelims is the stage of elimination. It is not the stage of selection. So there you need to understand that you need to be very focused, very precise on whatever sources you are reading. And trust me, once you have completed your syllabus, once you have seen the question paper, and once you have started taking the mock test, there is no one who is going to beat you from clearing this stage, because this has to be the easiest stage of all the three. Only thing is that you need practice. For the prelims, you need to practice as many as model tests as you can. And for the second stage, that is mains, I will say the same thing. You have to focus on the answer writing as much as you can. And finally, for the interview stage also, I will say that you have to give as many as mock tests as you can. Now, why I am saying this? See, the syllabus is big. Competition is huge. So you need to somehow minimize the ambiguity in the process. How to minimize? This is the way. Practice. But when you are practicing, the approach should be very rational and scientific. Again, the same thing. Syllabus question paper is speaking to the people who have qualified or who are guiding you. Fine? Apart from all these things, I would suggest that in order to analyze you, people would ask me that whether should we go for a coaching institute or not. It's a very, very genuine doubt, because a lot of information is available on the net. See, personally, I would say I had taken coaching, I was benefited by it. There are many who have not taken and they have also gone to clear this exam. So there is no hard and fast rule. Only thing is that you get a sense of direction, because the syllabus is huge. So what not to read and how to read, it should be told to you on daily basis. Because every new subject which you are starting, let's say you do not know what to neglect and how to read, you will be wasting at least 3-4 days in reading things which are not important. So there the idea of taking coaching will help. But otherwise also a lot of people have done it without going into any kind of coachings. So it is entirely your decision. If you have a friend, if you have a peer group where 4-5 people are preparing and they are like fully focused, they want to clear this exam at any cost, it's fine, you can continue with that. But always be in touch with the people who are from different backgrounds, who are from the different optional, who are taking classes in the different coaching institutes, because that gives you a variety, and which is very important in this exam. Because ultimately, every day, you are developing your personality. Yes? So overall, this exam is one of the easiest exam, provided you know the strategy which we just discussed. Apart from that, you need to be very, very, very focused. Now, I'll talk for 5 minutes on how to be focused. How many of you have started preparing for this exam? Somehow, like some modest start. Okay, at least we have one hand. Anyone else? 2 hands. Nice. I'm sure all be log honge. Don't worry, we're not going to ask you any questions here. Agar shuru kiya to bata do. It's good. Starting early always has some advantage. Okay, since you have started preparing, do you feel at times that it is too huge of a syllabus? It is not possible for me to qualify this exam? Does it happen? Firstly, because of the myth of 18 hours. And then again the myth of 5 year. See, there are people who were working, they took leave, they studied for 6 months, they qualified, got into IAS, now they are doing very well in their careers. I will tell you one very important thing. You should be clear in your head, why do you want to do civil services? I mean, we are living in knowledge economy. There are lots of wonderful options available for you. You can travel the world. India is doing very well in lots of, sectors. You can have a good life. I mean, there is no foundation to come back and serve the country. You go to dusty places and implement government schemes like Swachh Bharat, do policing, curb naxals, fight against insurgents and terrorists, or do some diplomacy in foreign service. Bring taxation from the Indian Revenue Service. It's not at all important. You can have a very good quality of life if you want in other areas also. But when you are doing civil services, I will give you some examples. As ma'am was saying, I will again take a cue from ma'am. It was like, people from all the backgrounds have qualified for this exam. From the top-notch schools, from the worst of the schools in India. And now here I am generalizing, I am assuming the government schools are not good in our country, because that is actually the situation. But people who are from the government school are also topping this exam. People who are from the best of the schools are also topping this exam. I have a friend working in Haryana cadre. He changed 4 to 5 services. Like earlier he was an airman, then he qualified the bank PO, then he got to qualify the state civil services, then the revenue services, now he is an IAS. I also have a friend who was working in, like she is my junior, who was working in New York, Manhattan, office on 42nd floor. She came back to India, prepared, now she is in civil services. All these people, meet them, ask them, why do you want to come, why do you want to get into the services? Everyone will tell you the same answer. The answer is, I will explain with an example. There are cases at times where you meet a person who is trying to get land documents or any important essential document from, you know, like past 15 years or 20 years, but they are not getting it. I know the system is having some of the problems, but who is going to fix that? We, all of you, all of us, रंग दे बसंती देखी है सबने, remember that, कौन साफ करेगा, हम ही करेंगे ना, this is what, the person told me that, you know, if somebody is not able to get his important documents or like land deeds or records or some property dispute, some murder case, and when that case is solved by that particular officer, the facial expression which the person is having, the sense of gratitude that person is having towards the officer is your biggest reward in this service. Nothing beats that. I'll give you my personal example. I am yet to go on the field. I was called by someone. The person told me that, sir, I am a dentist. I married off my sister to a dentist in a state of Maharashtra, a district called Palghar. How many of you here from Maharashtra? So no one, no problem. There is a district in Maharashtra called Palghar. Suna hai kisi ne Palghar ke baare mein? Koi baat nahi. It's great that ma'am has heard. सी जब यूपीएससी प्रिपेयर करना शुरू करोगे सब कुछ पता रहेगा कहाँ पे कौन सा डिस्ट्रिक्ट है कहाँ पे कौन सा नेशनल पार्क है रिवर है सो वंस यू स्टार्ट दिस प्रिपरेशन यू विल बी अ चेंज पर्सन डेफिनेटली सो आई गॉट अ कॉल फ्रॉम द डेंटिस्ट ही टोल्ड मी दैट ही मैरिड हिज सिस्टर टू अगेन अ डॉक्टर देयर इट ऑल स्टार्टेड दैट ऑन द डे ऑफ द मैरिज इटसेल्फ दे मेड सम ऑफ द डिमांड्स ऑफ डाउरी And somehow or the other way, they were convinced that my sister is very happy, we should arrange for some dowry, which they should not have. They arranged it. They had given huge sum of money for the marriage. It boils down to somewhere around 40 to 50 lakhs. After that, what happens? That one day, there's a news that his sister is dead because of an electric shock. So that was unnatural death. That person was trying to get an FIR registered in that district from past 1 month. And there he got me contact, he called me up, sir, this is the case. Can you please look into the diary and the record and please ask someone. Fortunately, the SP of that district was my senior, he was known to me. I requested him, sir, if you look in the merit of the case, if you find it is like a genuine case, please take the action. On the very next day, the FIR got registered and I still have his message in my mobile phone which says, so this is the idea of civil services and this is what is expected from young officers. And he was all in tears. So what I will tell you is it's not the idea that this is something which is supreme. Again, there are personal choices. There are a lot of people who are going for national development through doing good work in education, working with some NGO, or doing better for the country abroad. This is one way, but one of the best way. So if you are really convinced that when you want to get into services, you want to do something like this, nothing is going to stop you. Nothing. Because the motivation for this exam comes from inside. There are two types of motivation. One is extrinsic, one is intrinsic. So until and unless you have that intrinsic motivation, you will be facing a lot of difficulty to clear this exam. Ma'am would speak, I would speak, I will go. You'll be motivated for, let's say, we have the liberty to assume, let's say for 1 week. What after that? Remember Gandhiji. Gandhiji NCERT is a book, make front page, mein Gandhiji's talisman is written there. Just read that. Go back today, read that, those of you who have not read that. Try and understand what Gandhian philosophy is all about, Antyodaya. Helping the person who is last in the line, who is in the margin. So if you have that sort of inclination, and if you really want to make some change, you are going to clear this exam, definitely. So I think in next like 2 minutes we'll be starting with the Q&A session, because that is more important, because it should not be a monologue. We should not always be speaking. So in next 2 minutes we'll be starting the questions, but before that I would like to read something for you, just to give you some sense and perspective regarding a great person, how his motivation, in fact this poem has personally helped me a lot in my preparation, because I qualified the revenue services in my second attempt. In my first attempt, I did not clear prelims. So this, the poem goes like, there is a movie called Invictus. How many of you have seen that movie Invictus? Madiba, it was based on Nelson Mandela's story. So go watch this movie, it's an awesome movie. There is a poem written by William Ernest Henley, he's an American poet. He writes, and this is what is shown in the movie, that when Nelson Mandela was on Robben Island for 27 years, he's writing this, he came back. He should have actually not forgotten, he should actually have not forgiven the people who were responsible for, you know, 27 years of his life to be wasted. But he said, you know, like, I now want to build a country and I'll take everyone together. So he recites a poem and it goes like, out of the night that covers me, black as pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be from my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstances, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the blood drunings of chance, my head is bloody but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears, looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the ears find and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishment the scroll, I am the master of my fate, I am the captain of my soul. Thank you very, very, very much. Now I think we'll open the floor for the Q&A. So if you have any queries, we'll be more than happy to help. Thanks. So it's like, it's a very genuine question. All said and done, it's a competitive exam, it's tough. बहुत सारा ज्ञान दे दिया आपने, बट आफ्टर दैट ज्ञान क्या होगा? देर विल बी सिचुएशन इन विच यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू क्वालिफाई. सी, एज आई टोल्ड यू विद माई एग्जाम्पल, आई वॉज नॉट एबल टू क्लियर प्रीलिम्स इन द फर्स्ट अटैम्प्ट. दे आर मैनी लाइक मी, लास्ट अटैम्प्ट एक बार भी नहीं हुआ, बट दे वेयर लाइक, देर इज अ वर्ड कॉल्ड परसिवियरेंस. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू शुड हैव दैट इन यू, बट यू नो इट्स नॉट ऑल फिलोसॉफिकल, इट्स नॉट ऑल इमोशनल. If you have 6 attempts, if you are preparing for this exam, at least in first 2 years, there should be no plan B. You should devote 2 years of your life to change your life and lives of many, many in our country. If at all, in those 2 years, you are not able to make sense of the idea of UPSC, then you can start talking to the people who are preparing for this exam, and also to, you know, experts like ma'am. Like, what should we do? There are multiple options. There are many people who, along with the preparation, they are also doing masters or like post-graduation, giving some or the other exam, trying for fellowships, trying to go abroad. So do not stuck with one idea for long. But again, if you have that internal calling that, yes, I'll do it, then you should definitely give it one more try. I perfectly got your doubt, and I really wanted that somebody should ask this. Sit down. It's a very genuine question. At least she made an honest attempt to read the newspaper. So let us give a big round of applause to her. See, no book cover to cover, it also means no newspaper cover to cover. There are only 4 to 5 pages which are very important for you when you are preparing for this exam. It has to be the first page, which is the covering all the national news. Just a glance of that first page. You must read the editorial page, that's very, very important. All the articles and editorials which are there, you must read it, that page. It is of 2 pages, one is like the normal page, one is the open page. Apart from that, just the economy, which is business page in The Hindu, economy in Indian Express, and finally the world or the international affair, depending upon the newspaper which you are taking, Hindu or Express. These 4 pages. Anything more than this, you just need to glance. That will add to your knowledge and like knowledge repository, but these 4 are must. Having said that, once you start reading it, if you are reading newspaper for like the Hindu for 10 days, you will also see that a lot of newspaper items or articles are from the same topic. Now, once you have read about something happening in the Indian economy, let's say GST, some good people will be writing about GST, you have read entirely about GST in detail. Two articles if you have read, you have made notes of those articles, do not read the third one, or if you are reading the third one, just glance it. So ideally, when you start reading newspaper, initially it will take 3 hours. There's no problem, take 3 hours. But gradually you will be reducing the time. Don't ask me what is the exact time when one should do it, because there is no one answer. But at least those people who are saying that you can read Hindu in 15 minutes, they're lying. It's not possible. I hope we answered your question. Ma'am will add something on this.
Apart from the pages that he has told you about, many times when you read Hindu na, wo bahut heavy ho jata hai, theek hai? So Saturdays and Sundays you get the magazines also along with Hindu, and many times cover stories are there, like piche aapki Rohingyas ke upar there was a cover story, theek hai? Kabhi aapki kisi koi bhi current issue pe the cover story. So in one go you are getting the whole stuff there. At least, है ना, मतलब basic points आपको मिल जाते हैं, and these are the fodder points which you can use in your ethics and in your essay papers, ठीक है? तो ये जो आप general पढ़ रहे होते 4-5 पेज, वो तो आपको रोज पढ़ने, but yes, कभी कभी होता है कि off beat भी जो चीज़ें होती हैं वो बहुत काम आ जाती हैं, because now if you see the trend, questions are changing. No more very simple questions. They are asking you very twisted questions, ठीक है? Like last year they asked you कि what are the negatives of आईटी हब्स, ठीक है? तो अभी आईटी हब्स के नेगेटिव इन्वायरमेंट के अलावा क्या क्या चीज़ें हैं जो हम रोज़ न्यूज़पेपर में पढ़ रहे होते हैं कि क्राइम अगेंस्ट वुमेन, सोशल इश्यूज एंड ऑल दोज थिंग्स. सो कई बार वो, मतलब द थिंग इज व्हेन यू आर रीडिंग न्यूज़पेपर, थोड़ा सा इंटरेस्ट हो जाए, साथ में क्वेश्चंस देखो, फिर वो आपको और फोकस कर देता है कि क्या पढ़ना है और कैसे पढ़ना है, कौन सी इन्फॉर्मेशन कहाँ काम आएगी. यस, see, regarding coaching institutes, like he has also mentioned, like it's not a compulsion, but yes, they provide you some guidance. And as far as like which coaching institute is good and which is which is going to fulfill your demand, honestly I would say you find out, list bana lo 4-5 institutes ki, then go and meet the teachers there. Ultimately, it is the teacher and student connect, ठीक है? Many times it happens कि okay, this institute is good, but the teacher is not accessible to you. They are not very friendly, ठीक है? बहुत commercial है, करो जाओ, doubt आप अपने आप देखो क्या करना है, ठीक है? So, it's personally when you interact with the teachers, और आपको लगता है, और ये भी होता है कि supposedly I am also expert in something and he is also expert in the same field. Both of us are expert of say history. Both of us are very good history teachers, but you might be comfortable with him, you might be easily understanding him rather than my lectures. So it's again I would say ki kisi ko bhi rate karne se pehle jao, dekho jo cheez aapko lag rahi hai theek hai wahan aap jao. And second thing is regarding your NCERTs, whether you should finish NCERTs and then go. See, coaching institutes, whenever you go, the maximum duration for any course is 10 months, theek hai? Foundation course. We have 2 months courses, 3 months courses, theek hai? Ab wo 10 mahine mein, can you think of such a vast syllabus? Theek hai? Wahan pe kya hoga? You are not prepared about, say for example, economics. Wahan ja rahe ho, they will be not telling you the basic term. So if you are prepared yourself, then it will add to your, that it will be more effective for your time and money that you are wasting there or you are utilizing there. ठीक है? It all becomes waste or utilization अगर आपकी preparation है कि नहीं है. नहीं तो क्या होता है, preparation नहीं है, आप चले जाते हो वहाँ पर, कुछ समझ नहीं आता, लगता है इट्स अ टाइम वेस्ट, कोचिंग से क्या हुआ फ़ायदा, एंड मनी तो गया ही गया. सो इट्स ऑलवेज बेटर प्रिपेयर, एटलीस्ट अपना बेस प्रिपेयर करके फिर जाओ और जाके मिलो. अगर आपको लगता है कि द पर्सन इज सेटिस्फाइंग माय नीड्स, देन ओनली जॉइन. ठीक है?
सी, शी हैज आस्क्ड टू क्वेश्चंस. फर्स्ट इज लाइक, व्हाट आर द प्रोफाइल ऑफ द सर्विसेज व्हिच यूपीएससी इज ऑफरिंग यू? देयर आर ऑलमोस्ट 24 सर्विसेज व्हिच यूपीएससी इज ऑफरिंग यू, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम यू नो आईएएस, आईपीएस, फॉरेन सर्विस, रेवेन्यू सर्विस, टू रेलवे, टू अकाउंट सर्विसेज, टू डिफेंस अकाउंट, to all sort of services like postal services, AFHQ, and there are n number of services. See, please try and understand, in any service which you are entering, you will be given some or the other leadership role. Be it in defense account service, be it as the SP of the district or the SDM of the district, whatever you will be doing, you will be in some or the other leadership role. So if I need to categorize, what are the works? For AS, it's like, AS is somewhat more broad. In IAS, I will be working on all the government schemes which you are reading, the implementation of all those schemes and the civil administration, basically the civil administration. In policing, all about the policing, I mean, that's very obvious, the kind of different faces of policing which is changing in the time of social media. In revenue, you are bringing a lot of, you know, taxation, how you are bringing revenue to the government of India. Foreign services role is defined, so on and so forth. See, what I'm saying is, we should not say that because of some or the other idea, this service is better than the other service. Because now the time has changed to such an extent that people who are even top rankers, they are going for revenue service. This year, I think rank 41 or something, like she had gone for revenue service. She could have easily got IAS, but it depends upon the personal individual preferences. Yeah, yeah. 13th rank is IPS this time. And it is like that only, because if you really feel that I come from a background, let's say I have studied accountancy and commerce, or you are a master's in business administration, and you really feel that you will be able to do better in revenue services, it's good that you are going for revenue services. Because earlier it was the idea that, you know, like AS first or FS first, then IPS and then other services. It's not the case anymore. So what you can do, all of you can read the profile of the services which is available on the website of DOPT. Go and basically read about the 24 services which UPSC is offering. So you will have some sense that what each service is asking for. Then again, you can interact with the people who are in the service and others also to get a first-hand perspective at how they are working and what they are working. Now, having answered her first question, your second question was regarding my personality test. See, again, this I don't know how it is going to benefit you, but still I'll tell you. Personality tests are generally based on like 4 or 5 major areas. First would be your educational background. Second would be your state where you are coming from, your district, the district which you are coming from. Third would be, if you have worked somewhere, your work experience. Most importantly, the fourth one would be your interest, hobbies, and the kind of things which you have done throughout your life. So in these areas, questions would be asked. So for me, if I recollect, in the two of the interviews, it was mostly on my profile, because I was kind of, you know, active in my college. I worked with some of the NGOs like Gates Foundation. I also worked with some of the organization, arms of the UN. So entirely it revolved around that you have done so many things in life. You are not going to stop here. You are going to leave the service. So why should we take you? These kind of questions, you know, they'll ask you. They'll try to put you in some stress situation. You are made for something else. Why are you coming to civil services? So you need to convince them with your idea of civil services. With an example here, somebody coming from Kashmir, somebody coming from Kerala, Northeast, Bihar, UP, all of you cannot say that I want to become an IAS or a civil servant because, you know, I want to bring some change, I want to do this, and all the stereotypical answer. Because they also know that these answers are prepared for you. You have been tutored. So abo kya karte hain, bolenge iske baad kya, ye hame pata hai. Iske baad batao, why you want to get into services. So my idea, it's personality test, it's not interview. So always try and give original answers through which you can stand out. Work on your strength, minimize your weakness, and you'll do very well. See, there are two things here. Opportunity cost will always be there. So if you are planning to go for masters and you are also planning to go for civil services, so there will always be some or the other opportunity cost. If you're not doing your masters and if you're fully preparing for like full-time preparation for UPSC, so you might always think that this exam is very tough, I might not be able to clear, and if now I'm not going for my masters, so I'm wasting my time, my academics bhi kharab ho raha hai. So what my suggestion is that many people have done it after masters, many people have done it after PhD, many people are just graduates. So, there's nothing bad if you plan to do masters. In fact, if you are doing masters in your subject, you can very well take that subject as your optional, and that helps. Ideally, what we have seen with our experiences, so people who are from the subject, they have a bent of mind, they have inclination. So your answers would be different from a person who has no background in that subject. And the people who are evaluating your papers are mostly the university professors. So they would understand that this person is coming from that background. this person is being tutored or he has actually read some notes. So there you can create an edge, you will get more marks. But having said that, also always try and see like what time, what year you are planning to. You should clear that first, then only you should try and weigh the pros and cons and then go for it.
Online coaching is becoming a trend right now. Many of the institutes are giving online coachings also. What happens is many of the students are not in a position to come to Delhi. They don't want to come to Delhi also because of environmental issues and security and safety, and living in Delhi and preparing for UPSC is also a very costly affair. You go to the Rajendra Nagar and for basically for girls, if you find a good PG, 20-25,000 rupees to waise hi lete hain, theek hai, so it adds to your cost. So what happens is ki online coachings are beneficial. The only thing is you must go to the coaching institute, inquire from them ki okay, whether it is interactive coaching or not, or it is just a lecture they are giving. Now what is happening is like in our institute and a few other institutes, what they do is ki okay, when the class is happening directly, they are at the same time you are doing the class from your place, and if you have any query, you can ask the query that time and it will be handled then and there only. So you will feel that you are in the class, okay? And then online coaching does not mean you cannot interact with the teacher later on also. Like we provide that kind of thing ki theek hai, agar aapko baad mein bhi baat karni hai, you can always talk to the teacher. So it all depends ki online ke liye bhi many students are opting for that.
See, it's like a basic, a very generic thing. Please try and understand, this is a very productive age. Like this time, the kind of energy which you have, if you are clear with your idea that you want to do this exam, it's always advisable to start early and give you 100%. Now we are living in the world of, you know, like IT revolution, and you'll be reading all about 4th industrial revolution, artificial intelligence and things like that. Now customer is the king in today's market. So tomorrow, if you want to choose even a shirt for you, you will go to 5 different websites. You will try to see the reviews, you will ask your friends. This is also the same way when you are choosing a coaching institute, when you are choosing online or offline, always see which technology is better. If it is through VSAT, if it is through some other ways, if the interaction is there or not, always try and see which suits you. A customized product is something which the customer would like to buy, right? So according to your needs, you should decide, and for everything in UPSC, do that. Ek shirt ke liye karo yaar, ye to bahut badi cheez hai, kar lo.
See, what happens is कि जैसे आपने कहा कि आप हिंदी से हैं और हिंदी में ही लेना चाहते हैं, ऐसा नहीं है. आप देखो, हर साल हिंदी से भी बहुत बच्चे कर रहे हैं और हिंदी के भी बहुत सारे अच्छे इंस्टीट्यूट्स हैं, ठीक है. और वो अब मेन प्रॉब्लम क्या, मेन फाइट आती है आपकी, द हिंदू और इंडियन एक्सप्रेस जो करंट ओरिएंटेड आपके न्यूज़पेपर जो यूपीएससी को फोकस करते हैं, वो अंग्रेज़ी में आते हैं. बट अब ऐसा है कि बहुत सारे इंस्टीट्यूट्स हैं जो कि इनको जो है इनका ट्रांसलेट करके इनका एडिटोरियल्स वगैरह भी निकालते हैं. बहुत सारी आपकी मंथली मैगजीन्स हिंदी में आती है. तो ऐसा कोई, ऐसी कोई मतलब डिफ़िकल्टी वाली बात नहीं है. और रही बात कि आपके ऑप्शनल हिंदी के लिए, तो वो फिर आपको थोड़ा देखना पड़ेगा कि कौन से टीचर या कौन सा गाइडेंस, या फिर आपके अपने ही कोई पीयर ग्रुप में आपको गाइडेंस मिल जाए या आपके कॉलेज में मिल जाए. बट ऐसा नहीं है कि हिंदी के बच्चे डिसएडवांटेज पोजीशन में हैं. हाँ, अब बहुत सारे इंस्टीट्यूट्स इस चीज़ को समझ के कोप अप करवा रहे हैं.
See, I'll tell you basically, when you are appearing for the mains, once you have cleared the prelims, there is a form which is called as detailed application form. In DAF, you have to fill your preferences. Like whatever service you want to put at the first preference, you can put. Similarly, all the 24 services. Or if you do not want to give like weightage to some or the other service, you can take 5, 6, 7, 8, depending upon your individual interest. Once you have done that, depending upon your rank, depending upon your rank and the preference which you have taken, you will be allocated a service. Once the allocation is not star marked, which is a confirmed allocation, in star mark the services can change, upgrade, or like at times also it has downgraded for some of the other stupidity of people who have not taken the options correctly. So once the allocation is confirmed, you have to serve in that service throughout your life. Point is, if you want to change the service, you should appear in the exam next time, and then you can change the service. That's